When someone mentions chainmail, do you think of the medieval ages, or do you think of your inbox folder on your computer, full of spam? With today's documentary, we hope to show you what chainmail really is, how it started, and what it's become today. First used in late Roman times, chainmail was a type of flexible, protective armor that was used in the medieval times. By the time of the Norman conquest, the coat was long and fully sleeved, a hood usually fitting under a helmet. Tiny metal rings entirely made up the armor. Medieval armorers interlaced the rings, which were closed by welding or riveting. In the 8th century, mail was a short coat with a separate sleeve for a sword arm. By the 12th century, mail was fitted to hands, feet, and legs. A form of chainmail was even used by tank crews in World War I. In many ways, the chainmail of medieval times is comparable to today's body armor. Here is an example of body armor used by the US Army today. Some types of today's body armor even have their own built-in air conditioning. So what do random people today actually know about chainmail? How much use was chainmail during the medieval ages?
It was of much use.
Oh really? And how do you back up your answer?
Because we have movies to tell us that.
What is the historical significance of chainmail?
I don't know. So that they can protect themselves?
Alright. What do you believe is the historical significance of chainmail armor during the medieval ages?
We didn't really get a response we were looking for, so he left, or he really had to use the bathroom.
Alright, how do you believe that chainmail has evolved into today's body armor?
Well, I believe that very much.
What is the historical significance of body armor today? Alright, what came first, the chicken or the egg?
The egg.
So what came first, the chain mail or the plate mail?
The chain.
Is that what you believe?
Yes.
Oh my god, dun dun dun!
Alright, well the question is, did plate mail or did chain mail come first? As far as we know...
Chain mail came first, which was followed closely by plate mail, which was made with metal plates. In later times, knights would arm themselves with both chainmail and plate mail. Bringing up an entirely different question.
Hello, good sir.
Hi.
What would you rather have, chainmail or a ballistic vest?
Repeat the question. What's a ballistic vest?
We'll repeat it. Would you rather have chainmail or a ballistic vest?
Oh, a ballistic vest.
And why is that?
Because it sounds cool.
Do you believe a ballistic vest is bulletproof?
Yes.
Is it? Let's find out.
It turns out yes. Ballistic vests are bulletproof, having seen use with police forces and military agencies worldwide. So the answer is yes. But, is the chainmail we made bulletproof? The secret agent on the other side of this door has on our chainmail. A
obviously our chainmail didn't protect him as much as we thought.
Being our inquisitive selves, we asked a couple other people what they thought.
Seriously, do not like being on camera.
And we happened to be in a fabric store.
Do you think Shelf Liner is bulletproof?
Yes, I think it is.
We searched around for a couple more people to ask, but the only thing we were able to find was a poor little green monkey, who happened to be unavailable for comment. This brings up a new question. What if, during the Middle Ages, you were poor? Too poor to afford chainmail at all. What would you use in your defense? A trash can? What if you hid in your trash can till your enemies walked by? Then you ambushed them.
And that is why you shouldn't hide in a trash can. But what does that have to do with chainmail, you might ask?
Okay, maybe that last bit didn't have anything to do with chainmail at all. But, you know, we put it in there because it was funny, right? At least kind of funny. Alright, fine. Whatever.
What happens if you went swimming in water with chainmail on?
Well, excuse me, sir. Do you believe that someone with chainmail on would have died and drowned in the water?
You know what, dude? I don't even care, man. Like, you just gotta roll on and move on with life.
What are you doing in my car?
Because, you know what?
Get out of my car!
Bad things happen when you don't.
What are you doing in my car?
You know, I'm just rolling on with life.
What?
As you can tell, we didn't really get an answer we were looking for, but what can you do? Another example of armor today is this motorcycle armor.
Well, I hope you've learned a lot on our show today. We talked about everything from ballistic vests to shelf liner. Hope you learned about a lot about chainmail, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
What are you doing in my room?
Cut. In many ways, the body armor of medieval times is comparable. Ah, stop.